this time, our public hearing meeting, item number B. Public hearing to receive comments regarding the FY 2018-2019 budget priorities. I declare this open meeting closed. Can I get a motion?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
Got a motion and a second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Individual delegation wishing to address the commissioners at this time.
No one other than Mrs. Shaw's family.
The lady that was going to speak downstairs, that, ma'am, you can speak at this time if you'd like.
I was just speaking on behalf, just like they were saying, you know, well, the look at my mom, you know, I stay in Clark, she stay in council. But it seemed like when I got that phone call, there was no way I could get there fast enough. But to see her sitting out in the car and seeing that house burning down like an inferno. Like my sister then said, she had to pass that every day. She stays with my sister from the patchy wood separated. And all her memories, all that's been gone. She couldn't afford insurance. She's on a fixed income. So we're out trying to do the best that we can to try to help her, trying to lighten her load a little bit. But, I mean, it's discouraging when you're sitting there and you know that she's trying to do the best that she can, because she's very independent. She don't want us, you know, doing for her. She likes to do for herself. And to see things not, she's trying to move the way she wanted to move it, you know. So that's why we're out here, we're asking. I mean, if you just take it into consideration, and we have to pay, we have to pay in our bed. You know, I haven't been to that.
Have you got a cost, ma'am, on what it's going to cost to have it torn down?
Well, they said it was.
We had some estimates that came out and said that they would charge like $4,000 to $5,000 to level it and take it out and just be through, but somebody can just go ahead and try to put something else there.
And that $4,000 to $5,000, that number that they gave you, did that include the dump fees and all that?
No, sir.
So you can ask a question. You want us to pay for demolition or for this disposal?
No, just the hauling of it.
Just the disposal.
Yes, just the landfill. No, not the.
Just landfill fees.
Just landfill fees.
Right.
Did he give you any idea of the weight involved and what he thought the cost would be?
Did he have the weight? He was asking about the weight.
I thought you said that 15 trucks, 10 ton of truck, 150 ton.
It was saying it's, he guesstimated at 10 truck loads. And a truck load is average of 15 tons. And they charge $45 per ton at the landfill.
Okay. I make a motion that we approve.
I second.
Thank you.
Okay, we got a motion and a second. Is there any discussion? No discussion this time? Yeah, the only thing that I would ask is in reference is to the cost. Because we have to look going forward with other situations and requests like this from people. That would be the only question I have is what dollar are we dealing with at this time?
You said $45 a truck load?
It said $45 per ton and guesstimated about 15 tons per truck. You guess around up to 10 foot loads.
$6,750.
How much is that?
$6,750.
Let me ask a question. What type of house are we talking about? Is it brick?
Brick house.
It's a brick dwelling, 4-bedroom, 2-bath, with a den.
How many square footage was that?
I'd say around 2,000.
We ain't putting 150,000 tons in no house that size.
Based on weight, Mr. Peterson just did the numbers over here, that's a little over $6,000, $6,000 to $7,000.
Have you got more than one of us? There's a couple guys that I could hook up with that does this, and you go over, look at that. I don't have no problem helping at all, don't get me wrong. The only problem I have is when you do it one time, you know, to kind of set the standard, have to do it for other people. But I know you need help, and I don't mind helping you. But we can help you by getting you some, contacting some different contractors too, and I don't know any contractor you talk to. I know Sutton does it, and there's K and S in Blackburn, Henry Cemetery does it, you know Henry?
I heard of him.
He does it.
Yes, ma'am, but let me clarify my statement there. I'm like Mr. Peterson, I wanna help too, but I wanna know to what point and how much money we're talking about, so I can feel a little bit better about what we're talking about in dollars and cents. So I would like to ask for some time and to get some more accurate, some numbers, so the commissioners here, because I can gather there was some concern about how much we're talking about.
But, because I'd like to rescind my motion, it's fine, and we will revisit it at the next meeting, what we want to do, Mr. Chairman.
That's fine, as quick as they can get the information and get it back to the county manager, and then we'll definitely put it.
Give me back, so we know what the cost, the actual cost is gonna be. But that seems to be. If you'll leave me your number, I'll get your number to those guys.
Yeah, because some of the guys have just put it in back over, and they won't even put the landfill, some of the stone, they can just put it in place, some guys are hard to replace and put it field. I encourage you, man, if you have a brick, you don't have to put it back.
Not in my boy, right now.
That was my question. I thought you were talking about the stuff that they bring to the landfill itself. Am I correct?
Yes.
We're basically talking about the debris for, it's not the entirety of the house, not lacking what, the metal or whatever, but we're trying to get it to the landfill fees, not the actual people coming out to do the work, because we have people coming to volunteer to do that. But we're trying to get the fees waived per truckload to go there.
No, the reason I'm saying is brick does not have to go into the landfill.
Okay, I understand what you're saying.
The insulation, those part, that part has to go into the landfill.
But I do have another question. Now, being that she's got her own property, can this be buried on her property, or is a?
If she has enough space to bury, yeah, if it's brick, you bury it.
I don't think so.
You can bury the brick you can, you can't take the wood and the burnt charred. I mean, you can bury brick now.
Like insulation, all that stuff like that, yeah, insulation, wiring, stove, refrigerator, washer dryer, all of that goes to landfill.
You all are only talking about the landfill fees, not the transportation to the landfill.
Right.
You're only talking about the fees for the landfill.
Right. Yeah, that's, based on what the gentleman's comments, the tonnage that they told, I mean, we equated to what we have to collect, and that's not us making money, please understand that, this is what we have to pay. And we're just, based on the information he gave us, was the amount of tonnage that would be on per truck coming to the landfill. And that's what these numbers equate, and that's the way we understand it.
Yeah, I think it's fair to say that we're gonna help you, we just wanna get a better figure of what we're gonna do, if that's okay. Is that okay?
That's fine.
And Ms., but can you do one thing for me, please? They just removed the building downtown here, the paper store. Those guys took the metal out of it, took the wood out of it, took all the contents out of it, and they sold the metal to different people. They took the wood debris and carried it to the landfill, and then some other guys hauled the brick off, and I know where they put it at, they put it in a hole, did not carry it to the landfill. So you need to ask them how they're gonna dispose of that, so you can get your costs on, how they're gonna dispose of it.
Are you all aware of what the place he's talking about?
Yes.
The old Cape Fear.
And just tore down.
Old Hardee's.
Old Cape Fear.
The old Hardee's.
Okay.
Presentation of the 2016-17 audit. Mr. Brian Scott.
Good evening. Again, we come for y'all to make our presentation. We'd like to thank the board for allowing us to continue to be your auditors. It's always a pleasure working with Greg and Lisa and the staff. Everybody throughout the county and all the various departments have always been helpful and quick to respond to any of our needs, so thank you very much. appreciate all the help they've done.
Yes, sir.
You got a copy of the bound audit as well as the audit presentation. I'll go through it fairly quickly. If you've got a question, please don't hesitate to interrupt me. If it comes to you tonight or later on in the week or next month, my office is right down the street. I'm always available to discuss anything you. Tonight, I do come before y'all to present the audit and also to communicate our required communications. That starts on page one of our presentation. It's our responsibility under generally accepted accounting standards to express an opinion, and we did. We rendered an unmodified opinion, which is the highest opinion that can be rendered in such an engagement. We're also required to let you know how we plan to perform our audit to obtain reasonable assurance, and that's not absolute assurance because we're not able to look at every transaction throughout the county. We determine our audit procedures based on our risk assessment and also our evaluation of the internal control throughout the county. We communicate any matters to management and we try to resolve them. If not, we come before you and explain any issues or findings. We let you know about any known or likely misstatements. Each year, there are certain adjustments that are made. We give those to Lisa. Lisa consider those and then we'll post them. All of those that we gave her, she did post. There was none that she did not post. We don't have any responsibilities once we do issue our engagement. Moving on to significant accounting policies, we do review those in the bound copy of your financial statements. They begin on page 22 and just give you a kind of a detail of how the financial transactions are recorded and listed and reported in your audit. There were none that did not lack authoritative guidance, so we didn't have any issues with the way they were presented. There was an adoption in accounting policies, and that was pretty much throughout the nation as regards to your law enforcement law enforcement officer separation allowance. It just is a bigger number that we have to show as a potential liability that is done by actuarial. Based on that and other accounting policies we reviewed, there were no significant estimates that we deemed were not correct. All the disclosures were neutral, consistent, and clear, and we had no difficulties during the audit nor disagreements with your manager. As I mentioned, we did some adjustments. They were reviewed and accepted and posted. Management did sign off on representations, which clarified that they did not withhold any information back from us and gave us everything that we asked. Consultations with other accountants, there were none. There were no other issues. Other findings are listed in detail on the next few pages. That's the compliance section. We have a finding for segregation of duties, as well as an issue with the Medicaid process as far as the application for eligibility. Moving on, that's pretty much for my required communications. I'm going to kind of hit a few of the financial information. I know Lisa does a great job with her dashboard. Nice slides just give some color to your day, I would hope. But the first slide just gives a cash, and I'm looking on page 11. It gives a cash analysis over the past 5 years. That's the general fund. You see it did grow to a little over $20 million. Next slide shows the progression in your proprietary funds, which is water and solid waste. Slides 13 and 14 show a five-year comparison of your general fund revenue to expenditure, so you can see how each one has changed over the past 5 years. Slide 15 shows general fund balance. General fund balance did grow. Of course, you knew that you sold home health and got $1.9 million, and that certainly did help grow the fund balance as it has to 35%, which is a little over the state average. But as you're also aware, that money is set aside by the board for future use. Flipping to slide 6 and 7, just a continuation of the fund balance, how it's separated between what is restricted that is not allowed to be spent except for that specific purpose, as well as a growth track compared to the county average on slide 16. Slides 18 and 19 just show you a breakdown of your general fund revenue by department and sales and service, ad valorem taxes, other taxes, and restricted grant money. It also shows that on slide 19 for 2016, so you can compare ad valorem taxes with 51% in 2016 to 49% in 2017, so you do see changes. Slides 20 and 21 do the same thing, but for general fund expenditures. you can see, each department of the county where it was in the total budget for both years. Slides 22 and 23 give you a revenue analysis for the water fund and the solid waste revenues. There again, you see what water sales have done over the past 5 years, waste disposal, tipping fees, and so forth. Sadly, interest income is not showing up anywhere, but looks like it might start to put a little bit of color back on the financial statements. The analysis on pages 24 and 25 deal with the water fund expenditures to revenues as well as solid waste revenue expenditures. So both of those funds did operate in a surplus. Your solid waste was around $121,000 and water was around $105,000. The last two slides deal with property taxes. You can see the green bar is the state, which is a little above 97%. The county is almost 96%, so a little bit below state average. And you also can see that last slide shows the total valuation of your property. Slight increase over last year. Any questions on any of the financial information that I kind of flew through?
Motion to receive the fiscal year 2016-17 audit.
Second. Got a motion by Mr. Peterson, a second by Mr. Duggan. Any questions? All opposed? Any, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Thank you, Mr. Thompson. Finance department, Ms. Colvin.
Good evening, Tony. I want to review the month ending in January. That's 7 months into the year at 58%. Revenues was collected 59%, and we have spent expenditures of 49%. Jail construction, we're still moving right along with that slowly, but we are getting there. Solid waste, we've collected 64% and spent 57%. Emergency telephone, we've collected 41% and spent 51%. And water, we've collected 63% and spent 39%. Anybody have any questions on that short?
Thank you, Ms. Colvin.
Thank you.
Health and Human Services, Mr. Wayne Rain.
Chairman, members of the board, a few items tonight. The first one is presented as the sliding fee schedule. We usually do this once a year, whenever the federal government revises the schedule. It hasn't changed very much in a few years. The notice of family of four is still around $25,000. And this schedule was put in place for clients coming to the health department seeking services, and based on income, on a sliding fee scale all the way down to zero pay based on their income. And so we're presenting that tonight so that we'll be operating on the one that's issued by the federal government.
Most approved.
Got a motion by Mr. Peterson, a second by Mr. Goodman. Any questions? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
The East Carolina University contract, this provides for an arrangement for nursing students to rotate through the health department. So our staff, they can mirror our staff, and so on. This is a continuation contract, and the university is pretty late getting it to us. We tried to get this, they tried to get this to you back in November, but in any event, here it is, and it is a renewal.
Motion to approve.
Got a motion by Mr. Bull.
Second.
Second by Dr. Mondoas. Any questions? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed?
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Item C, approving, we're requesting, we've got an opportunity for a Blue Cross Blue Shield grant opportunity here, and the goal of the grant is, the grant program, is to accelerate the implementation of collaborative and lasting approaches to improve health. And I'm sure you're all aware that we have the opioid task force in place already, and this grant will provide to successful counties, the ones that are selected, up to $100,000 to support a planning period of 15 months. You get coaching, training, technical assistance, and so on. And then after that, if you have successful planning efforts with the counties or those that selected, will be eligible for four additional years of implementation support at up to $125,000 a year. And they're focusing on behavioral health issues, and that's exactly what the opioid addiction prevention is all about. The ultimate goal would be prevention because of the enormous burden that opioid addiction has to the county. So we have, the timeline calls for a letter of interest by Friday. So we're coming to you all, asking you if you want us to proceed on the grant application.
We got a motion by Mr. Coghill, second by Mr. Bullock. Any questions? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Thank you, Mr. Bullock.
Thank you.
I got one thing to question, ask you though.
Yes.
So many people in the department throughout the county wants to know, how can we talk you out of retirement to come stay with us?
We work on the math and.
And we do thank you also on the opioid. For those that haven't been, I had to miss this last meeting, Mr. Peterson and Mr. Wainer and everybody that's involved. I mean, every meeting is growing by big bounds. And any commissioner that hasn't had the opportunity to go, or any of the citizens, it's really taken on. And like I said, everybody involved has done a good job, and I commend all of them for it. Thank you.
Thank you, you've done great work. And I think that collaborative effort with all the people at the table and the community really enhances our efforts at being a front runner on maybe getting this grant.
Thank you, sir. Bladen County Animal Control, Donna Tuckman. Mike, come on.
Donna, that's the flu bug right now, so I'll get to grace your presence again. Thank you very much for the opportunity. It's certainly been a very exciting evening for you all. I am here to talk to you, and I think you have a copy in front of you of the ordinance change that we'd like to make. And it's around the surrender for quarantine required on demand. The only change that we are making is underline and highlighted, or other warm-blooded animal. The state vet said if it's a cat, dog on whatever, then it is not required for a quarantine. And we, in order to keep our shelter for the state will support our ordinances, we have got to change this to read the other warm-blooded animal is taken out of it. So the bottom proposed ordinance would read the exact same thing, except the other warm-blooded animal is taken out. This was presented to us by the state vet, and we took it to our vet of record, Dr. Hamby, and they were both in agree that it's not necessary.
Motion approved.
Got a motion by Mr. Peterson, a second by Ashley Trivett. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Thank you.
Thank you very much. Y'all have a good night.
Advisory board appointments. Lower Cape Fear Water Sewer Authority.
Motion to reappoint.
I make a motion that Mr. Rick.
What's the date factor on? There is, what, in 17?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Greg, we talked about that today. Have they made any efforts, or I mean, are they wanting to stay on?
I haven't had any conversation.
They want to stay on. Wayne said he just got appointed to two or three committees in the way of vote.
I have to.
Okay.
Yeah.
Take that back.
They're in the middle of the budget right now, what Wayne told me.
Can I ask a question though?
Yes, please.
Because I see that he came behind, that wasn't Larry Smith on the board, was it?
Yes, ma'am, it was.
That was same one. So I think, and that's who's going to ask him, Mr. Britt or someone, because if it was a board member, is any board member on that, commission on that board?
Not at this time.
Do we need one on that?
We haven't had one on there in several years.
If they want to stay on, I offered to go on because of the situation we got going on and be informed and work with the other counties. But if they want to stay on, I waived the opportunity for me. If they're happy and they're doing a satisfactory job.
But I'm saying, you said no board member, no commissioners on that board.
Amen.
Okay, thanks.
Can I get a motion?
He said.
Chapter two that's on. Mr. Peterson made a motion, second by Dr. Monsgoy. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? So be it. County manager, Mr. Mark. I'm sorry, White Lake Planning is on.
We need to push on to next week. I'm trying. I'm making phone calls every week.
Okay.
I have a hard time.
Got a motion to table, is that a second by, got a first by Mr. Peters, second by Mr. Bullock, table it to the next meeting.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'd like to review the calendar with you for the remainder of the month of February and as well as March. Remind you that we do have, the board does have a planning session scheduled for tomorrow afternoon at 4 p.m. at the Health Department. Also, the diabetes forums continue at Baldwin Branch Baptist Church on Wednesdays at 5:30 p.m. The Municipal and County Association of Bladen meeting is scheduled for Thursday the 22nd at 7 p.m. at the restaurant in Dublin. On Tuesday the 27th from 1 until 4, the Bladen County Dementia Friendly Kickoff meeting will be held in the auditorium at Bladen Community College. Moving over to March.
Mr.
Yes, sir.
I'm not planning a meeting with the, tomorrow at 4 o'clock. Did we do it last time about 2 hours? I'm trying to get a time for it. I got something that's going on.
That's our hope is to shoot for some time in that time frame. Yes, sir. I mean, that's kind of what we were hoping.
On the 22nd, Mr. Martin, I didn't make that one.
I forwarded that email that I've received from you to David Richardson, and if I hear from him, I'll certainly let you know.
Okay.
If he says that can be changed, I'll let you know. I know the notice is going out to all the municipalities,
right,
or whatever, so I don't know if it can
Thanks.
Be changed.
Thanks,
yes,
sir.
Okay, moving over to no other questions. Moving over to the month of March, the NACO Legislative Goals Conference will be held in Washington from Saturday the 3rd through Wednesday the 7th. On Thursday the 8th at 7 p.m., there will be a Parks and Recreation Master Plan community meeting that will be held in the library. Also that evening at 7, Bladen County Fire Association meeting will be held at the White Oak Fire Department. The Health and Human Services Advisory Board meets on Monday the 12th at 5:30 p.m. Also, the Board of County Commissioners meets that evening at 6:30 p.m. The next opioid forum will be held on Tuesday the 13th at 2 p.m. at the Bladen Community College Auditorium. On the 19th of March at 6:30 p.m., the board meets. There is a preliminary budget meeting scheduled for Monday the 26th, and offices are closed on Friday the 30th in observance of the Good Friday and the Easter holiday. One thing I noticed, Mr. Chairman, if I might just mention, on the Saturday the 24th, the Cape Fear Valley, I'm sorry that's not on there, but the Cape Fear Valley Foundation Gala or event will be held at Lou Neal that evening. It's, I think it's like maybe 7 p.m. Yes, sir, Mr. Chairman.
That's one. I was looking at that meeting on that Recreation Master Plan on March the 8th.
Yes.
At one time, we had spoken about allocating some time to kind of coexist with that master plan, with that proposed recreation and input we were talking about.
Yes, sir. And there'll be plenty of opportunities. This is just the first of, I know, at least two community meetings that will be held just to gather input from the public.
They're doing
surveys.
There'll
be surveys.
Surveys already out.
Surveys, yes, sir. So there's opportunity for comments.
So we have somewhere we're going to consolidate in for this?
Yes, sir. We'll be sure that you all have the opportunity to not only give your input, but also review the input that's received and that type of thing. So.
I have two questions, Mr. Chair. You saying that was that online survey that we did? Was that the one? For the
I'm not sure if that's the one.
Online?
I'm not sure if I remember seeing online.
I did one.
Okay,
it's
good.
Online.
Okay,
that
good.
One? Okay, that's the one. All right.
Okay.
So you get the input from that.
Good.
And can I ask you timing for that preliminary budget meeting on 26th? Have you come up with that?
I'm not sure if we scheduled a time or not. I think five, whatever time you, we can set that now. If I just noticed that there was not a time set, so. If you all would like to set a time now, it would be.
This is on what day now?
It's on the fourth Monday of March, the 26th.
The
it's our first budget meeting.
We used to do about 4
o'clock. As early as Dr. Montgomery's can be there as normally.
I don't have enough
on that date?
That day.
Okay.
You can't get it on.
We used to do about 4 o'clock.
We do it a different day or something.
What about in the morning?
If we need, I think that was just scheduled at the last meeting, or maybe the meeting before. So if we need to,
is it
still 6 weeks out.
Is it a small budget or is the whole asking.
It's just a preliminary, it's just a preliminary budget meeting to talk about kind of what we're seeing as far as requests from the departments and that kind of thing. So it's early stage budget meeting.
Y'all want to do it in the morning?
I just, y'all can have it.
I say about 10 o'clock.
That's fine.
10 a.m. in the morning.
Can you make that?
In the morning?
At the morning.
26.
I'm on my mark for 26. That's what we're talking about.
He won't be ready in the morning.
No, 26, the morning of the 26.
The morning of the 26.
Can you do it March 26th morning?
No.
No, 26.
But they can do it, I can do it at 4 o'clock.
At 4 o'clock morning.
So you can't do it on the 26th?
No, you can't do it on 26th.
27.
I can't do it that evening, before Christmas Eve.
On the 27th?
Yes, it is at night. Now, we did it at 4:30, 4:45. And if that long, I could get in, get out.
That's March 27th.
What day is that?
It's Monday, the fourth Monday.
What time you appear 27th?
Maybe 6.
I can't.
You can't come 27th?
I can't, but we didn't have a specific.
I can come anytime except the 27th at 6.
So what time can you?
So I can be here.
Any other morning? 3:30?
I can't do morning.
She can't.
Can you do 4 o'clock? Can you do 3 o'clock?
No, I can't do.
4:30?
I can't, look.
What about Thursday, the 29th now?
You said 4 o'clock.
29th, I can't do it all. 29th, I have.
Ms. Mungo, it's 4 o'clock is a good time for you, right?
If.
On the 27th.
I'm telling you, if you say 4, it'll take me, because I get behind bus, it takes me a little longer to come behind the buses at that time.
What time is good for you?
If you say 4, it'd be 4:10 before I get here.
Well, that's fine.
So if it's okay, y'all can do that. That's on 27th.
27th at 4 o'clock?
4 o'clock.
I just have to leave a little early, that's fine.
Yeah, okay.
Make a motion to move it from the 26th to 27th, 4 o'clock.
Second, and a second, thank you, Mr. Peter, second by Mr. Gooden. Move it to 4 o'clock.
4 o'clock on the 27th.
We're gonna be.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
The last item, Mr. Chairman, is for the board to consider approving a one-time donation to the Cape Fear Valley Hospital Foundation in the amount of $750.
Motion to approve. Got a motion by Mr. Peterson, a second by Mr. Gooden on $750. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? We got a question over here by Mr. Coggedale.
Now, Mr. Martin.
Yes, sir.
On this, would it be out of line of, if we just put this on the charitable contribution thing this time?
That would be our intent going forward, yes, sir.
All in favor, say aye. Opposed? Individual delegation wishing to address the commissioners. Correspondents.
May I ask?
Yes, sir.
When are we gonna address the rescinding the black policy? What are the plans around that?
Ask Mr. Martin, we need to set up some, a few little meetings to discuss. Some of the commissioners just wanted to have a feel for what the concern was and why changing, just to know. Didn't want to vote on not knowing.
Well, just for information, the Consolidated Health Board approved it, and it was recommended by the Health Director. For information only.
Say it again?
It was recommended by the Consolidated Health Board and the Health Director to rescind that policy.
With the interim director?
Yes.
Why?
Why do you want to change?
Why do you want to change?
Well, I think that just answered our question. That's why we want, and just so we can hear what the board's reasons was, and I think that's appropriate with the request, so we can have, feel good about doing it. Not that the problem of opposition, but want to discuss it, we need to discuss it.
Mr. Chairman, I think you all have handouts at your places for the information for tomorrow's meeting, so if you won't have an opportunity, or if you do have an opportunity to review it between now and tomorrow afternoon at 4 o'clock, that'd be, give you heads up. There's no action necessarily being requested tomorrow, maybe just to kind of give us direction as far as how to move forward on some things, no specific action. For our board planning meeting tomorrow.
It's great.
We have a handout.
Can we get a motion adjourned?
But they don't normally, normally we only have one, the only time we have.